Yeah, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Today I'm in Royal Forest again, in this amazing little piece of heaven I have found here. I'm very happy I found this place. It has a lot of tranquility and calm, so I love it very much. And I'm out here making a little trip, and I have to show you some things that I have made. This one, and this one, and something on my pack frame. It's some things I have made myself in the last couple of weeks, some projects, and I hope you like. So hang on. Yeah, and while I'm sitting here waiting for my fire to make a hot heat, I got me a drinking horn. I got it, took it with me, and today it's not water, or it's actually beer I have in this. Skål, everyone. yeah, I can see that the wood is very damp, so it's hard to get it started. But I think it will work eventually. I hope so. Now for the things I made. First of all, this one. Yeah, I weaved it with some willow branches that I found out in the woods, and it's for my backpack. I need more space for small things, small objects like these. So this one was a good solution, and it's actually not so easy to make a basket. I tried to make one with weaving on the bottom, but I didn't succeed in that, so I made one with a piece of wood as a floor on it, and then I mounted some sticks and weave it about, and some cordage to finish it up so it doesn't pop up. I think it's very cool, and I love it very much. It's what I'm going to need now on my backpack frame. So, yeah. And beside that, I told you about my lantern, my Viking lantern, and this is it. Yeah, I'm very pleased with it. I think it's so cool and just exactly what I want it to be. You can buy these on the internet, but I thought it could be a interesting process to make this myself, and I actually made a little video about this. I would like to show you that now, so hang on. Yeah, and first you have to make a template for your little lantern, depending on how big you want it. Then you make it in an hexagonal shape, so that it will fit the design that you have chosen. It's not so easy to make this. You can see I make a circle and then a triangle and then a triangle more, and after that I just cut it out with a sharp knife. Yeah, and here you can see the final shape and the markings are made for where the sticks are going to be. Yeah, and after transferring the templates to some wood, I drill out the holes where the small sticks are going to be. And of course, all in all, six small holes in the top and the bottom. Then I cut up the pieces, the small sticks I'm going to use. And again, depending on how big you want the lantern to be. So be careful that the sticks are equal in length. I used MDF wood for the top and the bottom, and pine wood for the sticks. And here you can see it's all, including the little holder for the candle. Then I glue it together with some special wood glue, and made sure that every stick had the same position and the length, so that the lantern will be equal. And here I glue on the stick for the candle holder. In a moment you'll see how it works. Yeah, has to be tight there. And remove all the glue. And then it fits down there, you can see. And the candle holder, I'll secure it that later. And this is how it works. And pull it up and down. Very easy. And then
I have to mount it, the top, including the candle holder stick. That's why there's a little hole in the top. You have to make sure that is. And now you can see how it functions. Yeah, very nice. Up, down. And now how you make the screen. You buy some chewing bones for dogs. I used the brown ones, they also came in white. After about 8 to 10 hours they have soaked in water, I take them up. And you can see they are very soft now. And make some templates for the screen. I made three because I had to make three out of this rawhide I bought. Just put it on and cut it out. It's not so easy. It has to be a very sharp knife. And then I mark the sides where the sewing is going to be. I used a felt pen and an awl to make the holes. There has to be small holes. And after that I begin sewing it together with some waxed linen thread. It's the same thread I'm using for my leather works. And again, be careful not to rip it in part apart. So gently sew it together. And I choose to use cross stitching, as I also use on my leather works. Just have patience and make the stitching nice and fine. And here I have put the three together before I close it, so it's going to be a round shape. Yeah, and I put in this these small sticks so that if the screen will shrink, it won't hurt the frame of the lantern. And that was actually a very good idea, because this material, the rawhide, actually shrinked a lot more than I have expected. As you can see later, how much. But it's easy to pull it over the frame now, and you can finish it up. I recommend you to make your screen a little bit larger than I have done, at least higher, so that it fits the lantern better when it's dried up. Then you have to let it rest for about 5 to 6 hours, maybe during the night, in a warm place, and the lantern will be finished. Here you can see it. I pulled this candle holder up, put in the candle, and lighting it. Then push it down. Now I'm turning off the light so you can see it in my workshop. It's very cozy, you have a nice light, a nice ambulance, I think it's called. And I'm looking very much forward to using that when I'm out making my Viking, especially my overnighters. Hope you find this little demonstration interesting.
Yeah, I hope you like this little video, and now I'm going to fire it up. Let me see. Yeah. And of course this is mostly when I'm out in the woods during the making an overnighter, but today I make an exception. And look at this cozy little lantern. I think perhaps I should find a stick that you can hang on here. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Doesn't that look nice? Perhaps a little stick here. Yeah. And I'm actually going to make a little lunch here. It's some bread I bake and some very special cheese that we have here in Denmark. I don't know if you're familiar with that, but let's see. A little bit closer. That'll do. And look at this, I made a little spoon for my honey. And when it's out here in the cold, it's about -2 degrees Celsius. This honey is getting very thick. So instead of getting my hands dirty, I can use this a little bit more, I think. Honey is very important in Viking food because it's the only way they could have anything sweet. And a little bit sweetness in the bread is very nice. And then some water. And those of you who are interested in the recipe for this, in the last Viking video I made, I put the recipe in the video description, so you can find it there. Yeah. A little bit at a time. And when it's getting like this, a little bit thicker and still a little bit wet, I can start using my hands. Yeah. And then I take half. And I found out last time that if I make it in this little ball, it's very easy to make the flatbread. I have to clean my fingers. I use moss here in the forest, and then I think I'm ready to make the first bread. Yeah. One of my clay pipes. Yeah. And this is the cheese I'm going to eat. It's called Danablue. It's a Danish cheese. And it's very delicious. And I actually got some strawberry jam to go with it. I like that very much. Now I think my bread is finished. You can see here, it looks very delicious. A little bit more on the other side, and then I'm thinking I'll be start to eat. Yeah. I'll make another bread. I'm not sure I can eat that too, but now I made it, so let's try. Oh yeah. And keep the fire going. First some cheese on. Yeah. And then some strawberry jam or marmalade. And then, yeah, doesn't that look delicious? I like it very much.
Yeah, it's boiling.
Yeah, and as I show in my latest video, I got me some clay pipes, and this is the longest one. And actually, I broke two very fast. They are not particularly durable. No, don't know if that's the right word, but they break easily because it's clay. So I had them on my table, and then unfortunately I put something on it, something heavy, and the stem broke on two of them. So I got this and the other pipe that I showed in the other video. Markus Fohr from Germany sells these pipes, and again in my latest video I have in my video description links for his Instagram page. It's a very cool pipe, I love it. What do you think about my hat, my new hat? It's a Birka hat, a replicator of the founders up in Sweden. I'm not sure, my wife says it's not pretty on me. Well, and I'm not sure myself, but it's warm and can keep me warm here during the winter. Yeah, but yeah, and this is my new bag. I made it again from linen, but this time I got some very heavy duty fabric, It's more rough and durable, and I love it very much. Inside I have a lot of things, my phone, my batteries, and so on, my wallets. But it's actually this symbol I want to talk about a little bit. This symbol is called the Wegvisir, and it's translated to showing you the way. It's a kind of compass, and they say that if it is carried on, you will never lose your way in storm or bad weather, even when the way is not known. So this will prevent you from getting lost in the woods, and that's a good thing. Although here in Denmark it's very difficult because we are a small country. But this symbol, there's some different opinions about the origin of this. Some say that it was used in the Viking Age, and some say that it's an Icelandic symbol that is only 100 or 200 years old. I don't know, but I think it's very beautiful, and that's the reason why I put it on here. And this symbol actually looks very much like another one that is called Eikihalmur, something like that. That is an old North or Viking symbol. And they said that if you had that on your weapons, you would never lose in battle, and it was protecting you. Vikings often wrote that on their helmets, and it's actually translated to shield. Aegis is shield, and Hjalm is helmet. So the Viking used that for protection when they are out and in war and so on. It's a very beautiful symbol, and had a lot of meaning also about Odin, I think. And there's something I would like to tell you about the runes that the Viking used. They were not considered as normal letters. They were considered to be magical and a part of their religion or their belief. And there's a story about Odin that spent a lot of days hanging from a tree, I think, until he found out what the rune meant. So for the Vikings, the runes were not only for bringing messages on, the rune also have some magical properties. And you can see now the sun is coming, perhaps that's why. I don't know. But a little story about my little haversack and the symbol I have on it. And these small branches are more dry and easily to light the fire with. So, very cool. Yeah, and some of you maybe have noticed I haven't got my Viking boots on, and that's because they don't have a good grip underneath. So I'm now out here and it's snow on the hills. I'm afraid I will fall down there. So I took my good old boots with me. Well, yeah, did I mention all the things that I brought with me today? No, there's something. Just a moment, I'll show you. Yeah, to be able to put this on my pack frame, I had to move my wool blanket down under. It's very efficient. You can see here, I made this so it can hang down here, and it actually works perfectly. So I'm very pleased with my new upgrade for the pack frame. I think it's looking very, very cool. Well folks, this is all for now. Thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft. I hope you enjoy this little video from my magical place out here in Royal Forest, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.